Advertising your business with GCN is simple, effective,
and more affordable than you might think.
Visit advertise.gcnlive.com for more info.
For over 25 years, Aero Precision has paved the way as a leading manufacturer of American-made AR parts. Aero Precision caters to the rifle builder by engineering quality receivers, handguards, and other essential parts. Aero Precision's added enhancements create a smooth build process from start to finish for beginners and seasoned builders. Whether this is your first rifle or your 50th, Aero Precision offers everything you need to make a quality AR at an affordable price.
Check them out at AeroPrecisionUSA.com.
Well, now we get to pull him off of his locked-in state and send him back to his home planet. And we're going to join him there on Planet Rick, joining us now from the locked-down environs of Michigan, is Rick Ector, the head of Legally Armed in Detroit, Rick's Firearms Academy. How's it going?
Hey, man, it is going well, about as well as can be expected. You know how we're living here in lockdown Detroit, man. I think they even put one of those anti-flying slash theft devices on my ship, man. I might have trouble taking off today. But the weather, man, the weather, I would say, is absolutely gorgeous. You know, the one thing about the weather is that it's been dry, you know, a little cool. But since I'm here, man, I've been out in the yard, man. I actually got some exercise and some fresh air, and I was in the yard, man, mowing and trimming and edging, man. I mean, have you been out? Well, how's the weather down there? You guys in the lawns and servicing your environment around your abode or what? How's
that? Well, I because of my advancing age and my dominating asthma, I pay somebody to do it, but they came by today and it looks great.
That's the way to go.
And now a lot of my neighbors have, I mean, they're I don't know if they give a yard of the year or yard of the month award in this neighborhood because I rent here, but everybody's in contention.
Man, that reminds me of the movie, what was that, Brewster's Millions, right? Was it, Richard Pryor?
When, yeah.
Right. He could either take like a lump sum of like $1 million or he could get like the big jackpot. All he had to do was spend like $1 million a day and couldn't buy the same thing twice and couldn't spend more than a certain amount in any place he shopped. Yeah, that's what that reminds me of.
Brewster's Millions. I don't even know if they can make a movie like that nowadays. I know they couldn't make Trading Places or Fast Times at Ridgemont High. There's a lot of movies they could not make today. They couldn't make Blazing Saddles today.
Well, they couldn't make Blazing Saddles because it was not very PC by today's standards. Now,
well, none of those movies. Trading Places was not PC.
Well, yeah, it wasn't. It wasn't. But you know what? I think Blazing Saddles took it to a whole different level.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I mean, it had everything. It had guns. It had violence. It had, man, it had all sorts of people in objectionable outfits, you know, by today's standards, you know, in that movie. And it was all for a laugh, man. But,
well, yeah, and comedy should be irreverent. It should be irreverent.
You know, there's one comedian out there, Dave Chappelle, who seems like he just does his own thing with regards to his actual content in his routine. But, man, I think he's you know, irritating a lot of people because I think we're so PC now, man, that comedy is not even comedy anymore.
Well, you know, the thing about Chappelle, though, is Chappelle has mastered one thing that everybody that's a conservative should master just for their own sanity. He learned how not to care what anybody thinks or says about him.
You know what? When the paycheck is big enough, you have the luxury of not caring if you offend people.
Right.
When you're doing your comedic routine, for
yep.
sure. Oh, man. So I guess you're probably thinking what we're going to talk about today, right?
Well, I'm wondering what we're going to talk about today. You're the one that has to think of it. I'm just along for the ride on the surface. I just ski behind your boat.
Right, man. So, you know, taking into account all the things that have been going on, I thought that a good topic to cover, considering all the things that are floating in the public space, you know, at least in the Metro Detroit area, because things have been really interesting around here. You know, this whole concept, this whole notion of race and guns. This is come to the top of the public consciousness here in the state of Michigan at our state capital in Lansing. You know, we just had that gun rights rally, you know, at the end of the month on the 30th. And you know what? People are still talking about it. But now, you know, the subject of race has now been interjected into the public discourse of the rally, man. So I thought that would be an interesting topic to talk about today.
Yeah, that's fine. Although I will say, I earlier before you came on the show, I was talking about how Sean Hannity got onto the protesters in Michigan that took guns to the Capitol.
Yeah,
and said that was the wrong thing to do and everything. That's a bunch of junk.
I wasn't planning on tackling Hannity. As a matter of fact, I saw like a blurb about it, but I didn't actually press play because I knew that I had a few conversations with a couple of people I needed to have, and I said, well, I'll just get back to that later. But that's, you know what? Save me the time to go to YouTube and push the play on the video. What was Hannity's rant about the protest?
He said it was a bad optic, right? And when I heard him saying this, when I read more about it than I heard about it, the only thing I was thinking is that, you know, he's a New York guy. He lives in New York. And
right.
this is a typical New York conservative, where anywhere else he's a Democrat. Getting out there and, you know, the purpose of if anybody wants to know what I think about it, I think it is a good, healthy reminder for politicians to have a little bit of fear. They should not be walking around thinking they are Teflon. They should not. They should understand that they have a responsibility and a fiduciary duty to do right by the people. And if they don't, then they should be reminded of it. And how can you be a Second Amendment supporter and not understand what the Second Amendment is about? It's not about saying, well, you know, a legitimate purpose of the Second Amendment is to go shoot some ducks.
You know, I had an exchange with a certain celebrity in the 2A space. I'm not going to mention who this person is, but
You might. You know what? I tell you what. We got a minute. You're welcome to mention him by name. I don't care who it is. I don't care if it's one of my friends. But I mean, we got a minute here. We got a minute here. And while I'm covering that minute, I need to tell you of this, just so you know. Now, starting next week, Planet Rick on Thursday will be occurring at 5 p.m. Eastern time. Because I'm changing time slots next week.
Okay. So I'm moving to 5 o'clock Eastern.
That's right.
All right. I want everyone listening to this to know that if you come at 7 p.m., you're 2 hours late.
You're going to have to
catch the replay over at lockandload.com.
Well, I always put it on Rick's post on his Facebook whenever I can, just so he can. That he's the only one that ever likes anything I post. And it's only when it's got his picture on it. So anyway, Rick is the head of Legally Armed in Detroit. He is the head of Rick's Firearms Academy. And we'll be right back. This is Lock and Load. We'll be right back.
away as a leading manufacturer of American-made AR parts. Aero Precision caters to the rifle builder by engineering quality receivers, handguards, and other essential parts. Aero Precision's added enhancements create a smooth build process from start to finish for beginners and seasoned builders. Whether this is your first rifle or your 50th, Aero Precision offers everything you need to make a quality AR at an affordable price.
Like a piece of Americana, this is Nighthawk Custom. Completing Browning's vision of the 1911, Nighthawk Custom is not a mass production facility. Each custom touch is machined to an exacting standard, with the heart and soul of each craftsman that takes it through the process. Traditional or tactical, Nighthawk Custom delivers a weapon you can trust with your life. Custom to your specification or ready to ship with the reserve line. For their complete selection, go to NighthawkCustom.com. Nighthawk Custom. One gun, one gunsmith.
So you're wearing a mask every day now?
Yeah.
Where are you getting them?
Same website where I get my neck and body wraps, sunnybay.com.
Really?
And they're handmade, just like their wraps in the USA.
Oh, and good quality?
Oh, very good. These are disposable face masks, and they make cloth face masks, too.
Good price?
That's the best part. 10 masks for only $6.
Wow.
As a public service, sunnybay.com is now making cloth face masks by hand in the Seattle area and sourcing disposable face masks with level 1 protection at sunnybay.com. Get a 10-pack of high-quality disposable face masks for only $6 or choose a handmade, washable, reusable cloth face mask with high 2 layers of quality cotton fabrics. Supplies are limited. Get details and order at sunnybay.com, a Biomed DB design company. Go to sunny-bay.com for disposable or cloth face masks. Just click sunny-bay.com. That's sunny-bay.com.
Frustrated trying to get business capital? Want to take the slow process and rejection out of the equation? GCNLoans.com removes the slow, irritating approval process. Instead, get quick, simple funding. Powered by David Allen Capital, 80% of our pre-qualified clients are approved in days. Pre-qualify at GCNLoans.com and get your money this week. It's that easy. GCNLoans.com. That's GCNLoans.com.
Let me ask you something. What are you doing when you put money in a 401k or IRA, or store jumper cables in your vehicle, or purchase health insurance? You're preparing. You're preparing to ensure you have enough money for retirement. You're preparing for when your car battery dies, or to have assistance paying a major unexpected medical bill. That all makes sense. The same goes for building a food storage plan. You're preparing for when emergencies or disasters strike and shelves go empty at your grocery store. The best way to prepare is with My Patriot Supply. They've helped a million hardworking Americans become more self-sufficient. My Patriot Supply sells hundreds of items, including dozens of emergency food kits, at MyPatriotSupply.com. It could be an earthquake, a cyber attack freezing our banking system, or a disaster that shuts down our power grid for weeks. For all these emergencies and more, get your supplies and prepare today at MyPatriotSupply.com. No more rushing to find empty store shelves because you're too late. Do it now so you're ready. MyPatriotSupply.com.
You've been hearing Dr. Wallach talking about 90 essential nutrients, keeping the body healthy. GCNteam.com now has Beyond Tangy Tangerine tablets, 60 plant-derived minerals, 16 vitamins, 12 amino acids, packed in a powerful tablet. But that's not it. 160,000 auric points, a knockout punch to free radicals. Call 877-878-4203 or go to GCNteam.com. That's 877-878-4203.
To you live. This is Lock and Load. This portion of the show is brought to you by Aero Precision.
For over 25 years, Aero Precision has paved the way as a leading manufacturer of American-made AR parts. Aero Precision caters to the rifle builder by engineering quality receivers, handguards, and other essential parts. Aero Precision's added enhancements create a smooth build process from start to finish for beginners and seasoned builders. Whether this is your first rifle or your 50th,
Aero Precision offers everything you need to make a quality AR at an affordable price.
Indeed. Check them out at aeroprecisionusa.com. We are speaking with Rick Ector, and he was getting ready to tell me about a little conversation. You can mention whichever pilgrim that you had this conversation with if you want to.
Nah.
Listen, if they said it, they own it, right? Right?
Well, yeah, but still, man, nah. But anyway, this certain well-known person, you know, in the 2A space, you know, on Facebook, you know, I'm going to quote exactly what he said. He didn't really go in heavy, but I took it a certain way, man. Quote, showing up to a reopened Michigan protest with an AR may or may not detract from that cause, but it definitely detracts from it. And I didn't quite understand exactly what he meant by that, but overall, I took it as a negative, right? It's a negative. You know, you're making a remark that I took as snide as gun owners exercising their 2A rights at the Capitol. Now, granted, you know, they were there protesting, you know, Michigan being closed over this coronavirus scare, right? Somehow we always get back to coronavirus, right?
Right.
So my comment in response to him is agreeing with Sean Hannity. Remember, we're talking about Hannity.
Right.
Does not make either of you correct. Men with guns scare sheep, and anger would be tyrants. And I went on in the next statement and said, I lost track of how many times I openly carried at rallies at Lansing at the Capitol. Let's just say a lot. You know, it's just one of those things that people typically do. And usually when I go to a gun rights rally, it's usually one of the rallies is sponsored by one of the gun groups here in the state of Michigan. You know, whether it's the one that's done every year with Michigan Open Carry and Michigan Gun Owners, they do a joint one every year. And then there's some other smaller organizations that have, you know, those rallies up at the Capitol. And I'll tell you, anytime that they invite me to come and address the crowd, you know, I always look upon it as an honor, and I always go down and speak anyway. And it's a good way to, you know, increase the network and get to know more and more people across the state. So when I see comments like that, man, it's almost like, you know, some people, and I guess it's a regional thing, you know, based on what your local laws are and what the prevailing attitudes are. But, you know, if you're open carrying a gun, you know, some people just frown upon it. You know, my thing is, if it's legal, and especially if it's customary, I don't see a problem with it. Now, what the people in the gun community will tell you is that, well, you know, it's kind of like you're poking the bear, right? And if you keep open carrying, you know, all of a sudden one day they're going to get tired of seeing you with your gun at the Capitol at a gun rally. Well, this last rally wasn't a gun rally. It was, let's reopen Michigan. I mean, we've been idle for 2 months now. And a lot of people are, you know, in a financial situation. No one is getting anything on the public dole from the government. And so people are like, hey, we've been down for, what, 2 months now. It's time to reopen Michigan and for us to get back to work. So, yeah, that was a big rally there, you know, and on the 30th. And it got a ton of media coverage, man, a ton of media coverage. And so our governor, by the way, she has been referring to herself in, well, this entertainer/rapper made a song about her and gave her a name, right? Took this pizza and threw these expensive glasses, are they Cartier glasses, and he dubbed her Big Gretch. I guess that gives her a certain cachet and street cred, I guess. And he actually put together a GoFundMe account and raised, you know, like a few thousand dollars to, you know, buy those Cartier glasses. And I guess she couldn't accept it, and she gave the money, or said that the money should go to this local community rights group. But the long and short of it, you know, our governor, you know, Big Gretch, as she's referred to, this rap artist, you know, she had one point to make in about the protest. And I'll say this. The one negative that you can encounter when you invite a lot of people to a gun rights rally, man, or in this case, a reopen Michigan rally, and you're pulling people from different segments of the society, you know, sometimes you'll get someone who'll do something objectionable. And yeah, I would say this one individual out of the thousands who were there did something objectionable, something that I would not have the taste of doing. He actually had a sign, and it had a Confederate flag on it. So that obviously rubbed a lot of people the wrong way, and I certainly don't condone it, just for the simple fact of, you know, what it means to a lot of people in the history, you know, behind that. There was this other flag, though, that had the likeness of the governor, you know, with her right hand extended out at a slight angle like Hitler did, and with a penciled-in mustache, you know. And it was basically talking about her heavy-handed close Michigan over this COVID virus thing.
Yeah.
You know, and I can understand how some people could take that negatively. And you know what? You never, ever want to offend people. But just in the sake of, you know, open and clear dialogue, you know, those things, you know, have no place in our society. But having said that, I don't think that those two particular instances in a crowd of thousands of people, you know, it takes away from the intent of the citizenry and the people who are definitely protesting, you know, the things that are going on right now here in the state of Michigan with us being shut down. And, you know, it opens up that whole conversation about race and guns, because what the governor said is that she found it, you know, personally objectionable, and she was trying to color the event as negative. And
Let me get you to hold right there. We will launch into this proper when we get back. Rick is, look him up, R-I-C-K-E-C-T-O-R. He is everywhere. We'll be right back. This is Lock and Load.
Holster.com, the home of DeSantis quality-built American-made products for 45-plus years. Supporting police and government contracts from first responders to responsible citizens. Holster.com is your source for quality American-made leather and kydex holster for the armed American. For concealed carry or open carry, Holster.com has what you need.
We didn't invent concealment.
We perfected it. Go to Holster.com now and buy a DeSantis holster today.
What's in a name? If that name is Ace Firearms, you've just entered a very expensive business. First, a fully appointed gun shop with all the guns, ammo, and accessories you could possibly imagine. But then you enter the manufacturing facility that is home to Red Alligator Concealment, Militia Arms Customs, and so much more. Ace Firearms is beyond a simple gun shop. This is a totally peerless operation. To find out more, go to acefirearms.com. Ace Firearms. This is only the beginning.
USA Radio News with Tim Berg.
Tyson's largest pork-producing plant in Waterloo, Iowa, is back running with limited production. Tyson's Shane Miller says employees will have to wear masks and have their temperatures taken upon arriving for work.
We're taking all the precautions that are possible to ensure that our team members are taken care of and that they're safe before they're coming to work.
President Trump and the First Lady celebrating National Day of Prayer in the Rose Garden at the White House.
America is engaged in a fierce battle against a very terrible disease. In times of challenge, our people have always called upon the gift of faith, the power of prayer, and the eternal glory of God.
President Trump also saying he's very happy the Justice Department is dropping its case against former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn, saying that Flynn is an innocent man. And you're listening to USA Radio News. A strike by some essential workers in the Windy City's been averted. As we hear from USA Radio Network's Chris Barnes.
Thousands of nursing home workers in the Chicago area and around the state of Illinois were going to be going on strike, but staffers at dozens of facilities avoided the stoppage by reaching a tentative agreement with nursing home owners for a two-year deal. The deal would provide them with hazard pay, paid time off, and resources to protect them and nursing home residents during the coronavirus pandemic. For USA Radio News, I'm Chris Barnes.
Three of JetBlue's New York-themed airplanes will do a low-altitude flyover over the city today as a salute to healthcare workers doing battle against the coronavirus. Healthcare workers in New York say they're moved that the airline is doing something to honor them.
I'm deeply humbled and appreciative that they would consider this and honor the healthcare workers.
The salute in New York is expected to begin at 7 p.m. You're listening to USA Radio News.
Attention homeowners that have ever had a broken appliance. That's a joke, right? We've all had broken appliances. I own a home just like you and have found a way for as little as a dollar a day to have all the major appliances in my home on a warranty plan. They're guaranteed to be fixed or replaced. You know how expensive an air conditioner, the heating system, a washing machine, dryer, water heater, or refrigerator can be. For about a dollar a day, all your major appliances are protected in case they break. Unless you're Daddy Warbucks or the Monopoly guy and you don't care about money, call my friends at the Home Service Club now and get a warranty on your major appliances. It's a free call and the first month is free. But be one of the first 25 people to call within the next 10 minutes.
800-825-6796. 800-825-6796. 800-825-6796. Again, that's 800-825-6796.
To you live. This is Lock and Load. This portion of the show is brought to you by Aero Precision.
For over 25 years, Aero Precision has paved the way as a leading manufacturer of American-made AR parts. Aero Precision caters to the rifle builder by engineering quality receivers, handguards, and other essential parts. Aero Precision's added enhancements create a smooth build process from start to finish for beginners and seasoned builders.
Whether this is your first rifle or your 50th,
Aero Precision offers everything you need to make a quality AR at an affordable price.
Check them out at AeroPrecisionUSA.com. Talking to Rick Ector, and we're getting ready to get into the meat and the potatoes of what his topic today, which is guns and race. So how shall we proceed, sir?
Well, you know, just to pick up the conversation, man, you know, I do a lot of talks, you know, in the local area and across the state about that very topic, man, about guns and race, man. And in Michigan in 1925, I would say the most pivotal moment, you know, was a court case that involved a doctor by the name of Ossian Sweet, who had a small practice that was growing because he was serving an underserved community here in Detroit, you know, in the black community. And eventually, you know, he got to a point where he wanted to, you know, get a home that was commensurate with his perceived standing in the community. And that involved him wanting to move to an all-white neighborhood. But back in 1925, man, you know, it was a different time with different attitudes, and a lot of people would not look kindly to him moving into this neighborhood that had these deed restrictions and deed covenants. But he conspired with the current owners, and they bought the home, and they moved in the middle of the night, and you know, literally next day, the neighbors found out that they had, you know, neighbors, you know, this black doctor from the other side of town.
Okay.
And
I like his style.
You know, these crowds, you know, and they were just growing every night as they were just standing outside watching this house and saying all sorts of things that weren't very nice and pleasant. Until one evening when someone from the crowd that had, by a lot of estimates, had numbered at least 100 people, you know, someone fired into the house. And Dr. Sweet, being a smart man, after all, he went to medical school, he returned fire. And then, and only then, did the police that were watching this whole thing unfold, did they decide to storm the house and take everyone into custody and take them for, you know, prosecution of the two people who died in the crowd, in the mob. So back then, you know, we didn't have things such as Miranda, you know, the right to remain silent, and you weren't afforded an attorney if you didn't have one or couldn't afford one. The long and short of it is that in 1925, man, in 1925, you can imagine things were a lot different in the 20s. But back then, an all-white jury acquitted Dr. Sweet of the death of the people who were attacking his home. But see, the great significance of that, man, is that in the state of Michigan in 1927, they implemented the Michigan Firearms Act, which was the most draconian collection of anti-gun laws you could ever think about. Michigan was among the most stringent states in the nation with regards to gun regulation. And so when I tell people that guns, you know, are definitely critical for personal protection and home defense, there's a reason for that. And when I talk to people about guns and race and guns, you know, there's a history there, and it's not very pleasant. It's rather sordid, and I call the people who commit evil against folks who just want a better life for themselves, man. You know what? I will not lose any sleep over someone who defends himself from those attacks, man. So as I share that message about the sordid and, you know, unsavory history of gun control, you know, the very next day after Big Gretch did her story, you know, we had a local activist, you know, he's the local NAACP president here in Detroit, and he took exception to one of the demonstrators who had an AR. He went and took a picture with two state troopers. Like, troopers are there, they're working, and part of their job is to make sure everyone at the protest is orderly and is not violating any rules, not putting anyone's safety at risk. So this protester, he struck up, I guess, a quick relationship with the troopers and got them to take a picture with him, which, you know what, I've done it myself, you know, just to be social and friendly and to document, you know, being at the event. Well, the local NAACP president saw that picture, and, I mean, he just blew a gasket. You know, his quote was, there was the reporter who actually covered the story in the local Fox affiliate, and his name is Randy Wimbley, and he goes, quote, if Randy Wimbley and Reverend Anthony came out to the state capitol and strapped up to the hilt, I would not be treated so great with tolerance, grace, and understanding and sympathy. You know, and so, end of quote. So when you see that, to me, that was like, okay, now the governor had her statement that she made the other day. So now she calls in reinforcement. She calls in the local NAACP head to make his statement in the media to vilify guns. And then all of a sudden she makes an announcement that she wants to, you know, take a look at people having guns on the Capitol, on the grounds of the Capitol, you know, at least inside of the building. Well, at the end of the day, man, it is the right of the people to confront, to protest against their government if they are not doing our bidding or doing our wishes. I mean, yes, we have the First Amendment, and that is to raise our grievances that we have. And yes, the Second Amendment, the actual displaying and of firearms, you know, is a reminder of why the Second Amendment exists. No one was threatening their safety. But I mean, in terms of the First Amendment, actually carrying your gun is an expression of the First Amendment. So there's been, you know, a lot of back and forth in the public media about guns and do the long carrying of guns have any place in today's society. And I will tell you, I definitely do believe that the Second Amendment is still relevant, and still addressing your grievances with the government is relevant, and bearing arms is most assuredly relevant. The thing that I find most disappointing, like in other states we've seen, where a simple election is lost and the wrong person gets in, and all of a sudden there's this radical move to the other end of the spectrum, and then there's a litany of draconian anti-gun laws that are being, you know, enacted. And I looked at, what state was that? Just now, while we're all going through this pandemic, is that they actually put in a bunch of gun control. Was that? What was that?
Hang on right there. Just hang on for me. We'll figure this out on the other side. And this is Planet Rick with Rick Ector. We'll be right back. This is Lock and Load.
Hi, I'm Dan Pilla. I started fighting the IRS over 40 years ago when they tried to seize my mother's house. I sued the IRS and won. I beat the IRS then, and I've been beating them ever since. I wrote the book on tax debt settlement, and I've helped thousands of people deal with tax problems they thought might never be solved. I can help you too. If you owe taxes you can't pay, don't wait another day. There's no such thing as a hopeless tax case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX or go to my website, danpilla.com. That's danpilla.com, danpilla.com.
This is a pandemic survival alert and the most time-sensitive messages you will hear this year. You still have time to plant a one-acre crisis garden and secure a supply of your own nutrient-dense food. But time is running out, and it's one deadline you don't want to miss. Who should plant a crisis garden? Individuals, families, churches, communities, anyone or any group that sees hard times ahead. Let's face it, even the mainline media is talking about food supply disruptions and the growing number of grocery store workers who are becoming sick. But there's more. Meat packing plants are closing, mile-long lines at food pantries, and more farmers now in financial trouble. The truth is, growing nutrient-dense vegetables this summer may be the single most important thing you do. Go to survivalseedbank.com and watch the new video to understand what we're really up against. Get free bonus seeds, special quarantine reports, too. Don't wait. Every minute counts. Go to survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com.
Houseflies defecate every 4 to 5 minutes, spreading diseases and germs. Protect your food and your health with Bug Assault, a miniaturized shotgun which utilizes ordinary table salt as ammunition. Non-toxic, no batteries required, only $39.95. Use discount code GCN and get an extra 10% off your purchase at bugassault.com. Fire your fly swatter. Get your Bug Assault today.
Would you like to get back that full head of hair from years past? Now, there is Reveal. Beverly Hills celebrity dermatologist Dr. Nathan Newman took nearly a decade to develop Reveal from natural botanicals to return to a full body head of hair. Reveal for men and women with a 30-day money-back guarantee at gcnlife.com or toll-free 844-443-6637. 844-443-6637. Reveal at gcnlife.com.
Get healthy, not high, with 100% pure CBD powerful natural pain relief from Veterans Vitality. GCN listeners, have you ever thought about how CBD may help you? I'm sure you have heard about the many benefits of CBD. Well, here's your opportunity to try before you buy. Created by veterans and for everyone who deserves better choices, our CBD is derived from organic hemp, grown in the USA, and third-party tested. Veterans Vitality CBD saves you as much as 25 to 50% over our competition, and a portion of all sales is contributed to veteran nonprofits and events. Many of our customers have experienced improved quality of life, help with anxiety, PTSD, and overall well-being. Our products do not contain THC. They are safe, non-addictive, effective, and 100% legal. GCN listeners, get your free trial bottle of premium CBD by simply paying shipping and handling at GCNFreeCBD.com. That's GCNFreeCBD.com. Again, GCNFreeCBD.com. Offered by Veterans Vitality Premium CBD.
Complement your health with hemp-derived cannabinoid oil. We've always believed that the closer to Earth, the better it is for our bodies. Our hemp-derived cannabinoid oil is phytocannabinoid-rich, full-spectrum, and organically grown. Finally, hemp made easy, clean, and effective. GCNHemp.com or call 877-878-4203. That's right, we cut through the red tape. It's now available at GCNHemp.com or call 877-878-4203.
This is Lock and Load. This portion of the show is brought to you by Aero Precision.
For over 25 years, Aero Precision has paved the way as a leading manufacturer of American-made AR parts. Aero Precision caters to the rifle builder by engineering quality receivers, handguards, and other essential parts. Aero Precision's added enhancements create a smooth build process from start to finish for beginners and seasoned builders.
Whether this is your first rifle or your 50th,
Aero Precision offers everything you need to make a quality AR at an affordable price.
Come out at AeroPrecisionUSA.com. Speaking with Rick Ector.
Rick. I remembered the state, Virginia. How could I forget Virginia? It's the state where NRA headquarters is located.
Yeah.
Imagine that. You know, all the, you know, heartburn we've experienced there with what's been going on in Virginia, man. You know, and it just underscores the fact that, man, we have to, like, come out and support gun rights each and every election. I mean, it just takes one election to turn the tide against us, man. And you know what? If they get in power on any state, in any state, they will relentlessly assault our rights without any qualms whatsoever.
Right.
Absolutely.
You know, the thing about that is, this is the only thing that, and it bothers me about Virginia, it bothers me about New York, it bothers me about New Jersey. All these places where right now they're getting a full taste of what their government is like, they voted those people in.
Or by default, they stayed home and assumed it was a lock and lost because they didn't actually enter a ballot.
Well, something, whatever it was, it doesn't really matter to me what it was. Like in Virginia, we know that 60% of the voters stayed home.
Okay.
In Virginia.
See, I'm guessing that they could have actually won that election had they turned out.
Who knows? Who knows with this? Northam, he's been running the whole time saying, if I get the legislature, I'm going to push for gun control. And they tried it initially when he first got into office, and that didn't work out. So now they've got it, and they do have it, and they are, and he's doing exactly what he promised he was going to do. He's one of the few, you know, a leftist politician who's actually was completely honest about his whole intention. And if the people of Virginia, if that's okay with them, what are we to do with that?
Right. If the people there don't take it seriously, then why should we? Is that pretty much the sentiment?
No, but I mean, I live in South Carolina, and I'm a Second Amendment advocate. You live in Michigan, you're a Second Amendment advocate. We're out there, we're pushing, we're punching, we're constantly in the fight every day, all day. One of the funnest things I get is when somebody sends me something on Facebook and says, "Will you help with this fight? We must fight." And I'm like, I do this every day. I'm fighting every day. And when a state, if an electorate fails to pay attention, or doesn't pay attention, or neglects to pay attention, or however you want to put it, what am I to do? What are you to do?
Right.
In some cases, the unfortunate thing here is this opens up the opportunity for the regular people who didn't think elections mattered to get a taste of the reality of how much they do matter.
Right.
To get a little negative reinforcement, I think, you know, if you want to put it that way.
And we in other states, man, we're learning, like you in South Carolina and me here in Michigan, we're looking at that and we're like, okay, we don't want that to happen in our respective states.
Right.
So we're going to make sure that we definitely do our part. The last piece of thing I wanted to talk about real brief, is real quick.
Sure.
Was yesterday, Wednesday, April 6th.
May 6th.
House Rep Sarah Anthony. She had three gentlemen who were carrying rifles who were escorting her to the state capitol building. Quote that was made was, "We want to change the narrative. First of all, we want people to understand that people of color can, you know, keep and bear arms the same as anybody else," end quote. Michael Lynn, who was one of the three black gentlemen who escorted the state rep to the actual Capitol building. And one of the great things that I liked about that piece was it actually showed the three guys who were carrying, they were three men of color, three black guys, and they all had ARs. And it answers one of the questions, or one of the comments that I get from anti-gun people, especially anti-gun black people, is, where are the black people? And how come the black people don't have the ARs, right? Well, here's a prime example, you know, in the paper, in the media, and they're actually doing it, and nothing bad is happening to them. Fear is running rampant through my community. They're scared to open carry guns at the Capitol.
Well, I hope not. You know, this is the thing. I saw Morgan Freeman being interviewed by Mike Wallace one time, and Morgan Freeman said, the only reason race keeps coming up is because we keep talking about it. So why don't we try this? I'll quit referring to you as a white man, and you quit referring to me as a black man.
Okay.
And Wallace didn't know what to do with that, because, you know, Wallace is sort of a leftist kind of dude in his time, and you know, race, invoking race is always, it's a thing. It's a distraction. It's like, you know, pointing, saying, look over there, elephant. That, you know, they're doing a distraction there. And I mean, if I see a person with a gun, the only reason it matters to me that they're black is if I'm calling a bar looking for them.
Right.
And I'm saying it's probably that black guy with the gun. And okay. I only want to, yeah, that's the only way I'm going to identify him that way. Otherwise, he's just a guy to me.
Exactly.
He's just a dude to me. And I mean,
it's just these anti-gun leftists who are pushing an agenda. They wouldn't know what to do with themselves if more black people or other people of color more. Well, I can't say fully adopt the Second Amendment. They just don't demonstrate. You know, they don't go out and participate in marches and in rallies. But I'm here to tell you, I see a steady stream of people of all races looking on to take on a more active environment in their safety, especially in this coronavirus era where we don't know what's going to happen with public safety in the coming days, weeks, and months.
Right. Right. Well, I kind of think I know what's going to happen with coronavirus. I mean, very shortly, the rest of America is going to be cut loose as, you know, most of America is monkey see, monkey do. That's why we don't have any toilet paper. And as more and more people,
our governors, she's been constantly been mentioned as a potential running mate for what's his face,
Biden, Joe Biden,
who's going through his issues with the woman that is alleging that he sexually assaulted her. You know, he's going through a thing with her. And by the way, our governor, who's jockeying to be his vice P running mate, she's actually siding against the woman and taking Biden's side. But what about that whole thing when the Supreme Court nominee came up and all the leftists were saying, believe all women, right? Well
you know, listen, that only applies if it's a conservative.
Obviously.
And, yeah, that only applies. Before we run out of time, tell everybody how they find you.
Rick Ector at Detroit CCW. You can find me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. 2,000 videos. Look forward to seeing you. And I look forward to seeing you next Thursday evening. Are we at the regular time or starting out the other time?
No. Next Thursday, it'll be the new time.
Next Thursday at the new time, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Planet Rick, here on Lock and Load Radio with Bill Frady.
There you go. That was he paid for that. He paid for that. He approves that message. Old Rick does. He approves that message. Thanks for joining me this evening.
Hey man, thanks for having me. See you next week at 5 p.m. Eastern.
Roger that. Coming up next is 1911 University with Joe Chambers. This is Lock and Load.
Makes top quality AR style firearms for sport, military, and law enforcement. 100% made in America parts and materials. We manufacture revolutionary three position binary triggers that can be selected to fire on the pull and release, or set to fire normally. We strongly support and uphold our Second Amendment. We hope you do too. Get a 10% discount when you mention the code word lock and load at franklinarmory.com.
Protect, hunt, compete. This is the mantra of CZUSA, delivered via a lineup of superlatives with handguns proven to function in both real world and competitive settings. Rifles designed specifically for the mission, whether it is law enforcement or built for the plains of Africa. CZUSA has engineered peerless reliability into their superlative product line. Go to cz-usa.com and find out what serious shooters have known since 1991.
You know what's really smart?
Wash your hands frequently, practice social distancing, and stay home if told to do so.
You know what's really dumb?
To ignore your immune system.
Right now, more than ever, your health depends on a strong immune system.
The experts at Immunocorp will give you their 7-step guide to immunity for life, free.
Why? Because we want you to be smart and healthy.
Simply call 800-446-3063 or click immunityforlife.com.
Immunocorp has been producing the world's leading immune system products for more than two decades.
To get your free 7-step guide to immunity for life, call 800-446-3063. 800-446-3063.
Be smart. Don't ignore your immune system. Your life depends on it.
Call 800-446-3063 or click immunityforlife.com. Immunityforlife.com.